हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ मोबाइल कंप्यूटिंग। वी आर प्रोसीडिंग विद द जनरल पैकेट रेडियो सर्विस, दैट इज़ द GPRS। व्हाट इज़ GPRS? वी हैव टू लुक इनटू द डिटेल्स ऑफ द GPRS। GPRS इज़ अ पैकेट ओरिएंटेड मोबाइल डेटा सर्विस अवेलेबल टू यूजर्स ऑफ द 2G सेलुलर कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम, ग्लोबल सिस्टम फॉर मोबाइल कम्युनिकेशंस, दैट इज़ GSM। It is also available in the 3G systems. In 2G systems, GPRS provides data rate of 56 to 114 kilobits per seconds. So, the speed has to increase. So, GPRS is a mechanism to transport high-speed data over GSM. GPRS has the ability to offer data in small packet at the speed of 14.4 kbps. To 171.2 kbps. So you can see the difference. In 2G it provides 56 to 114 kbps, whereas in when we talk about GSM, it provides 14.4 kbps to 171.2 kbps. So GPRS is a speed enhanced data transmission service designed for GSM systems. So what it does, it enhances the speed of the GSM systems. Speed enhanced data transmission takes place by packetizing of data and simultaneous transmission of packets over different channels. GPRS standard is defined by the ETSI, that is the European Telecommunications Standard Institute. GPRS is a packet oriented service for mobile systems. And mobile data transmission and their access to the internet. It uses unused slots and channels in TDMA mode of GSM for packetized transmission for a mobile station. If you remember, in GSM we use a combination of TDMA and FDMA protocol for the communication. So the unused slot of the TDMA are utilized for enhancing the speed by the use of GPRS. So this way, GPRS provides more speed to GSM network. What are the advantages of GPRS over the GSM? The GPRS provides the enlisted points below in the GSM network. What are those? It provides multimedia messaging services, that is the MMS. It provides the short message service, that is the SMS. It provides push to talk over cellular, that is POC or PTT. It provides instant messaging and presence, that is the wireless village. It provides internet applications for smart devices through wireless application protocol, that is the WAP, which we have used in the GSM as well. So it is an enhancement of over the GSM that it provides a faster protocol, that is the WAP. It provides point-to-point service, internetworking with the internet. Future enhancements are flexibility to add new functions such as more capacity, more users, new accesses, new protocols, new radio networks. So it is an advantage of over the GSM network. Then we move forward to the architecture of the GPRS. As you can see here in the diagram, how GPRS is made or how it is assembled. This is the architecture of GPRS. It uses GSM architecture for voice. GPRS supports a class of network nodes to offer packet data. These nodes are called as GPRS support nodes. GSM are responsible for delivery and routing of data packets between MS and external packet data network, that is the PDN. What is MS? Yes, that is the mobile system. We can simply call it a mobile system. And MS having GPRS capability stores CKSN, that is the cipher key sequence number, similar to cipher key stored in the SIM and the GSM. It also stores a TLLI, that is the temporary logical link identity, similar to TMSI in the GPS we had. BSS system existing in the network needs enhancement to recognize the packet data. BTS also needs to be upgraded to support packet data transportation. HLR needs enhancement to register GPRS user profile and respond to queries originating from GSN. So you can see that the architecture of GPRS is quite simple. We can see here in the diagram how the MS is connected to the BSS, and it is a little different from the GSM that we had studied in the previous lectures. Now we have the following new network elements to existing GSM network, means GSM and GPRS adds these to the existing GSM networks. What are these? These are packet control units or PCUs, serving GPRS support node or SGSN, gateway GPRS support node, that is GGSN, border gateway, charging gateway. We will come to each one by one. Let's go to first packet control unit or the PCU. The PCU separates the circuit switched and packet switched traffic from the user and sends them to the GSM and GPRS networks separately. It also performs most of the radio resource management functions of the GPRS network. The PCU can be either located in the BTS, BSC, or some other point between the MS and the MSC. There will be at least one PCU that serves a cell in which GPRS services will be available. Frame relay technology is being used at present to interconnect the PCU to the GPRS core. Second one is serving GPRS support node. What does this node do? It is the most important element of the GPRS network. The SGSN of the GPRS network is equivalent to the MSC of the GSM network. I hope you can recall what is the task of the MSC of the GSM network. So SGSN functions in the same way for GPRS. There must be at least one SGSN in the GPRS network, which was again and like we had one MSC at least in the GSM. There is a coverage area associated with the SGSN. As the network expands and the number of subscribers increases, there may be more than one SGSN in a network. That depends totally on the number of the subscribers in the network. Then we have gateway GPRS support node or the GGSN. What it is? It is a gateway to external network, means whenever external network is trying to enter, then it has to go through the GGSN. Every connection to a fixed external data network has to go through the GGSN. The GGSN acts as the anchor point in a GPRS data connection even when the subscriber moves to another SGSN during roaming. So like we had the HLR and the VLR in the GSM, similar is the GGSN, which is the anchor point even when SGSN is moving during the roaming. The GGSN may accept connection request from SGSN that is in another PLMN, means in another network or in another while during roaming, you can take an example. Hence, the concept of coverage area does not apply to GGSN. There are usually two or more GGSNs in a network for redundancy purposes, and they backup each other in case of failure. So this is the main advantage of having the GGSN, that it has a backup or option, that if one GGSN fails, then there is a backup GGSN which is having the details of the subscribers of the network. Then we have the border gateway. The border gateway or BG is a router that can provide a direct GPRS tunnel between different operators' GPRS network. Means if you are in one operator's GPRS and you want to switch to other operator's GPRS, then broader gateway is, it will provide you a direct route. This is referred to as an inter PLMN data network. It is more secure to transfer data between two operators, PLMN network, through a direct connection rather than via the public internet. So that is why the speed also enhances, because a direct routing protocol is there, which is the border gateway. The border gateway will commence operation once the GPRS roaming agreements between various operators have been signed. It will essentially allow a roaming subscriber to connect to company internet through the home GGSN via the visiting PLMN network. So when it is passing, when a subscriber is passing through the border gateway, then the border gateway will send detail to the home GGSN that yes, this person is trying to pass through my gateway. So this is a monitored path where subscribers can move from one network to another even when the operator is different. Then we have the charging gateway. The GPRS users have to be charged for the use of the network. So we already pay the charge. In a GSM network, charging is based on destination, duration, and time of call. I hope we see that whenever our call is being charged, then it is according to the destination, the duration, and the time of call as well. You can see that many companies offer free calls between 9 in the night to 6 in the morning. It means that during that duration, they reduce the call charges. So this is through charging gateway. However, GPRS offers connectionless services to users. So it is not possible to charge subscribers on the connection duration. So call duration will be considered, but connection duration is not possible all the time. Charging has to be based on the volume, the destination, the QoS, and other parameters of a connectionless data transfer. Means how much you are transmitting, where you are transmitting, what is the quality of your call. So on these things, your charge would be decided. These GPRS charging data are generated by all the SGSNs and CGSNs in the network. This data is referred to as charging data records or the CDRs. One data session may generate a number of CDRs, so these need to be collected and processed. The charging gateway collects all of these records, sorts them, processes them, and passes it on to the billing system. Here the GPRS subscriber is billed for the data transaction. All the CDRs contain unique subscriber and connection identifiers to distinguish it. A protocol called the GTP, which is GTP Prime, you can call it a GTP Prime protocol. It is used to transfer the data or the records between GSNs and the charging gateway. So this was what are the advantages which are being provided in the GPRS network in the existing GSM network. Means GPRS works on top of GSM network. I hope you like the video, and we'll come up with more details about GPRS in the next video. Thank you for listening patiently.